Today's question is, a child scratches his hand with a pen after which red beals appear over scratch sites and they are persisting for a period of 30 minutes and fade away after that. So what will be your diagnosis? So the reason why I have selected this question to be asked today is 1st October, which is World Urticaria Day. And if you have thought the answer as dermographic urticaria, then probably you are correct. Okay. So we'll see. So this actually happened that a patient came to our OPD and she was complaining that she didn't develop any wheals, which are characteristic primary lesions of urticaria. But she told that wherever she applies any pressure, there she has noticed that she was developing some reddish discoloration and itching was there. Then what we have done is, what we should do is we should stroke over the normal skin and this is what will happen. So this is dermographism, which you are now right now seeing, dermographism. Okay, so dermo skin and graphism is writing. So writing over the skin is called dermographism. Here you are able to see red lines which are strokes given with the key. Okay, and after that with the next step I have done is I have made a signature of myself. So here you are able to say, I will just remove this off. Here you are able to say I have just written my name over this. If you can read it, DrMSD. So do not worry, I have not tattooed over her skin. So it will just fade away after a period of 30 minutes. So this is the example. This is a type of inducible urticaria, also called physical urticaria, that is dermographic urticaria. Okay, we'll see few points about urticaria and related to its few points. Okay, the in primary lesion which is seen in the case of urticaria is a wheal. Okay, which is actually a triple response of Lewy's, which will happen after we stroke the skin of the normal appearing skin with help of any blunt object. Okay. So you can see that the center will be pale and periphery will have erythema or in a wheal, and it is going to have edema surrounding the lesion, and also the lesions are evanescent, that is wheals are evanescent. So what does this evanescent term mean? Usually this particular lesion, if it has developed today in the morning, so within a period of 24 hours this lesion will heal and it will completely resolve. And at other areas there will be development of wheals again. So this is evanescent nature and it is characteristic for urticaria. Okay, and it is classified based upon the duration. Okay, if at all the wheals are present only for a period of 24 to 48 hours, then we are going to call it as urticaria. And if at all they persist for more than 48 hours, that is 2 days, we are going to brand it as urticarial vasculitis. So this is a different entity, we will see it at a later date. So if these wheals are going to develop for a duration of less than 6 weeks, that is 1.5 months, we are going to call it as acute urticaria. And if they are going to be produced for a period of more than 6 weeks, okay, on a daily basis, then we are going to call it as chronic urticaria. And acute urticaria is it can be due to many reasons, spontaneous. It can be due to infections, bacterial, viral, fungal, infestations, scabies. So many reasons are there. And it could be also due to ingestion of the food, ingestion of the drugs. Okay, so all these are the reasons. And also, please remember, this is the important one here, in chronic form of urticaria, that is inducible forms. Inducible is also called as physical type of urticaria. And here examples are dermographism, which is the most common form of inducible urticaria. Followed by there are many minor variants regarding which we will discuss at a later date. Cholinergic, cold induced, solar, aquagenic, excessive, delayed pressure. So these are all part and parcel of inducible type of urticaria. So many patients are suffering with this problem, and many dermatologists, there are some other physicians who are treating this. So I pay my tribute to all the doctors and all those dermatologists who are treating their patients as their own family members, and they are trying to elevate the symptoms of these urticaria patients. So on this particular World Urticaria Day, I pay the tribute to all the warriors for fighting against urticaria. And also it is very difficult to live with urticaria because I have myself once got this experience of getting insect bite reaction, because of which I had wheals and it is crazily itchy. I can totally relate with the plight of the patients. So on this October 1st, that is Urticaria Day, I wish all the patients who are suffering would get some relief. And I wish very, I am very happy that all the doctors and dermatologist physicians are working very hard to help their patients in alleviating the symptoms. So this is what I have already told you. So scratching is called dermatographism, and that is, it is going to induce physical form of urticaria, which is the most common form of physical urticaria, and linear wheals will be developing as a result of firm stroking of the skin with a blunt end of the blunt object, okay, and it will fade away within 30 minutes, so you need not worry about that. So who cares? You care, okay. So October 1st, 2020 is the urticaria day. So this is graffiti. So I hope all of you know what is graffiti. This is graffiti writing over walls, okay. And this is dermatographism. This is dermatographism, okay. And this is more than dermatographism. So this is signing over a patient, the name. So do not worry, as I have already told, this is going to fade away, so no need to worry, okay. Yes, this was yesterday's question on dengue fever. You can watch this video also. So that's it.